Oh no. Oh no. No, no, no. Hold on. We gotta turn the music on. We gotta turn this up. Dude, our guy's going through it right now. I've been paying attention to what you've been dealing with. Brother, you take your time. Okay. Bob Kelly.
Yes, sir. Robert Kelly.
Robert Kelly.
The other R. Kelly.
What are you going through?
You want to tell the tale? The fact that you're even here.
Yes.
The fact that you're performing.
I'm trying.
Brother, what are you going through?
I'm trying to make it through. Around 5 days ago. Oh, God. 5 days ago, my kid had a vacation. And my wife planned a trip up to Mountain Creek ski resort for 2 days. And I don't ski, but we went up there. We drove up, brand new Ford Ranger I just got. Beautiful time, but great. And checked in, great room, fireplace. Kid
was excited.
Big day ahead. We all had snow pants and suspenders and snow boots and goggles.
Couldn't get any better.
God. Kid had a brand new helmet. I remember putting it on his head. And he was like, Dad, I love my helmet. I was like, I love it too. And we walked down the long hallway and down the stairs and through the lobby by a beautiful fireplace with a wood carving. Think of a moose. And went out to the bus. There was a bus. Shuttle bus took us over to this mountain.
So you don't even have to walk or drive yourself.
No, you just
Could
walk.
Could it get more convenient?
Yeah. And then we pull up to a little sign that says snow tubing. There's a bunch of families. Fire pit, laughter. You could hear laughter in the background. And then we walked up and there was a bunch of tubes. I should have known something was wrong. There was a bunch of tubes just strewed all over the place with nobody on them and nobody collecting them and filing them up and just everywhere. And then there was this funnel of people going up this people mover up a mountain. Nobody directing us where to go. Nobody telling us what to do.
Anarchy.
There's nothing. And just filing in and then my family and me got filed in with these people up this people mover. And all of a sudden we're on the people mover. There's no directions. There's no nothing. And I'm on it. My kid jumps off the people mover. And it stops, and nobody says anything, and I grab him, and I put him back on. It starts again, and he's scared, and he jumps off again. I should have stopped right there. I should have just went back to the hotel, but I didn't. I went up.
You stayed because it's his birthday.
I don't want to teach him fear, man. I don't want to teach him fear. I don't want to give him fear. So we go to the top of the mountain. We get off. I put my kid in a tube. Nobody says anything. Nobody says nothing. I shoot him down a mountain. And I get in the tube after him. I look around. And I'm pretty much the only 300-pound guy around. And I didn't know, but the night before, it rained out. There was no snow. It was rain.
Slick.
It wasn't snow anymore. It wasn't snow tubing. It was a luge, Olympic style.
A sheet
of ice. I get in my tube, which is basically a tube in a tube. If you look at my body's shape. And they waved the red flag down below. You heard over the walkie-talkie. Ksh. Okay, let them go. And there I went. But just before I left, I had changed lanes because my wife's hat fell off when she went down with my son. And I wanted to see if I could grab it.
All he does is think of other people.
Other people. That's all I want to do. It's my wife. I don't want her hat to fall off and my son to see, I can't get mommy's hat. No, daddy. Dad used to kill deers and bears for mommies and families.
This is the modern day hunter's activity to hunt mommy's dropped expensive hat that daddy most likely bought.
I bought. It was $4.
Money well spent.
I could have let this one go, but I didn't. And I go on this other lane not knowing you know, that this lane was a worse lane for me. Because now I get on the mountain, and I knew right away, first little bump I go down, I'm doing 9,000 miles. Shot out of a friggin' rocket. Because there's physics in going in. When you come down a mountain on ice, if you weigh more, I don't know if you know this, if you weigh more, you go faster.
Yeah, yeah. I've heard that. Inertia, yeah. I guess.
When you go to an amusement park, there's a height thing. You can't be this small to go on it. You'll fall out of the ride, little boy.
Yeah.
You can't go on this ride. You're not 48 inches. Sorry. On a ski slope, there should be a scale.
If you're too fat for the Black Diamond.
If you weigh over 250, I'm sorry, sir. We don't have the ability to stop you at the end of this hill. The technology doesn't exist. Yeah.
There's nothing we can do aside from a dragster parachute that you have to deploy.
Yeah. Yes.
Maybe.
Yes. We would have to have 90 fan boats at the bottom pushing you back up the hill.
Some long bungee-like contraption. So as you head into this fresh, ice-covered, tundric lane...
Well, you go down one hill, uh-huh. and then I try to grab the hat, but I miss it because I'm doing 9,000 miles an hour.
Your reflexes aren't that quick.
You're time traveling at this point.
I realize everything, the sides are blurs.
Okay. It looks like in Star Wars when they hit light speed.
Yes, yeah, exactly.
You're escaping the dreadnought from the Empire.
Yes, I'm with Chewbacca and the Millennial Falcon escaping from it, and I hit the... And so then I say, okay, now it's time to just hold on. So I hold on, I start spinning. So now I start spinning. I'm going 9,000 one way and around 5,000 the other way.
Oh, no.
Okay?
Are you screaming?
I'm not screaming because my son is at the bottom of the mountain. Have you been listening,
yes,
sir?
He's trying to set an example through bravery.
I tried to put my feet down, but they wouldn't go through the ice.
You can't even stop yourself.
I can't get through the ice. One hill. I got another hill. And the last hill, I'm coming down. And they
momentum,
have,
yeah.
They have like three doormats they got from Bed Bath & Beyond. One says welcome, one says goodbye, the other one says you're dead. I go over those so fast, there's fire on top of them.
It looks like the DeLorean just took off from the mall parking lot.
I don't make people laugh. So I fly by those, and then I run out of snow. That's how far I am. There's no more. Like, I am not on the premises, and like, there's no snow tubing. I go past the snow tubing part.
Where they rent them? Or
I hit dirt. Literally just dirt. The snow tube doesn't know what to do, so it stops. The tube is like, I can't go any further, sir.
This is where you get off.
This is where you get off. So it threw me, it bounced and threw me off into a hill. I was in midair, and I landed on my ribs.
Oh my God.
Just shy of a big red balloon that would have saved my life. And I landed on my ribs, and then my feet whipped over my head. And landed in the balloon. My feet, thank God, were protected.
Your feet are fine. You're still playing basketball.
I popped the balloon. So literally the ride was over for the day because they had to repair if you make it past this, you're dead. There's nothing we can do.
So what we'll do is we'll talk to Keith when we return.
Yes.
The extent of the injuries received.
Yes.
With that's Bob what I Kelly. Want to hear. It is a video worth paying for. I retweeted the link from your website. Please, JSS98Rock. You're going to want to go to patreon.com/Robert Kelly. It's worth the money. There's footage of the trip.
We have slow-mo footage, extended, magnified footage of the crash.
What happened to Bob when we returned? Robert weighing in at a thick 195 pounds is hauling ass down the side of this
thing. I would add another few hams to that.
Okay.
Maybe five more hams.
A couple of spiraled hams on this tube.
Yeah.
He gets to the bottom. He has lost momentum.
Yeah, no.
Snow stops. Yeah. It's straight gravel, straight dirt, bar mat. Yeah. Hits a big dirt hill.
Yeah, with
lobs his ass off of it.
Yeah, I literally land all my weight on my ribs, the left side. I hear, and then my legs flap into the balloon that I was supposed to land in. I just didn't make it because gravity and physics really played a big part in this. Man.
Not the fat man's best friend. Gravity and physics.
No.
Enemies.
No.
How long was the hill?
7,000 miles.
Give or take a mile.
It was shockingly long.
It was not a snow tubing thing. Like when we went sledding as a kid.
Yeah.
It's not that. It was definitely a mountain. It was half a mountain. It was I call it a ghetto mountain.
Well, if you have to ride up, you have to ride up. You
got to take a lift up.
It was a people mover.
That's a mountain.
So we went up to the top. It was four slopes, and then
sloping tubes.
Hang on a second. All right, so
don't make him laugh.
He's making him laugh.
We go, and when I hit the bottom, I was probably, no doubt, doing 98 miles an hour. I mean, not to 100. I mean, if you clock me, I was probably doing 98 to 100 miles an hour in a tube, backwards spinning. And I hit the dirt, and that's when the tube was like, I can't go any friction. A lot of stuff. Science.
A lot kicked of science. Your ass on the mountain.
Yes.
So when did it stop becoming fun when you went down the mountain?
Dirt hill showed up.
Like the 30th spin?
Well, what happened is that when I hit, everything in my pockets went flying.
Oh, okay.
So I just heard things. My lighter, my cigar cutter. I had like a gimbal for my iPhone that's just broke.
Monocle cracked.
All kinds of my cane.
Yes.
So,
my World War II flask.
The kid walks up and he goes, "Sir, are you okay?" And I literally went, "I don't think so." And he said, "Okay," and walked away. So
just checking.
So my kid runs up, "Dad." I have a 5-year-old.
Yeah.
Ooh, saw the whole thing.
He saw the whole thing?
Saw the whole thing. So
he probably thought it was cool.
He did. You can hear him laughing in the video.
Why do I imagine that it sounded
Dad, that's
this,
so cool.
This famous bit of audio right here that it had to sound something akin to
stop.
Right at the bottom of
very,
the hill.
Very ow.
He's in
it was
hell.
Very it was very similar to that. And then my kid runs up, so I had to suck it up real quick. He's like, "Dad, let's go." And I was like, "Okay." And I said to my wife, who my wife's from Boston. She doesn't like, she likes a man.
Tough
she,
as nails.
She doesn't like when you're sick, go to work.
Right.
Get up.
Right. Thank God.
I got one of those.
People still like that
just,
out there.
Just stop it. Get away.
Ugh.
So I walk up to her and she's laughing. She goes, Are you all right, honey? And I go, "No." She laughs more. It makes her laugh more. She's
okay.
Like, "Oh, what's wrong?" And I was like, I go, "Take the kid." She goes, I go, "Just take the kid." And my son's like, "Dad, come back up the mountain." I go, "I'm going to go get a Band-Aid. I got a boo-boo on my finger."
"Son, I need you to tell the world my story." tell him I was a good man. Your dad
tried on.
My wife.
Your ass up. We got cocoa coming. I ordered cocoa.
So I go and I stand behind a wall. I'm standing, leaning on a wall, and I had nobody. So, you know, lonely guys like me, where do you go? Instagram. You go to your Instagram story. Okay. You talk to your fans.
Your digital friends.
So I was like, I think I broke my spleen. I thought my spleen popped because I'm a big guy. Last time I had a physical, you get into a large spleen. We can't do your hernia, your belly button hernia operation because your spleen is too fat. So I'm like, my spleen's dead. I just exploded it.
I'm just filled with leakage right now. I've gone septic.
Yes, exactly.
I'm filling with turd.
I can... a guy walks by, one of the big... This kid. He's a kid. I go, "I think I broke my ribs." He goes, "No, you didn't. My mother broke her ribs. You wouldn't be able to talk, but I'll get somebody anyways."
Thanks for the support. Was this mountain
at
in
that
Boston?
Point? You probably wanted to have your ribs broken just to prove him wrong.
I wanted to find a rock. And I wanted to bludgeon him inside of a tube.
Where were you guys?
Up in Jersey somewhere.
Oh, yeah. The mountains of New Jersey.
Beautiful place. Beautiful place.
God's country.
The Appian Mountains in Jersey.
So you're at this point, are you feeling, because you said you heard the crack, the crunch inside. You're convinced. Your ribs are broken.
Well, it's broken, so I had to get this guy comes over, a very nice guy, and I go, listen, my son's here. I don't want him to freak out. Can we please walk? Can we go behind, like over here behind this house? It was a little weird. listen. Hey, dude, can we go behind the house?
Listen, can you take me behind
that brown bag with you?
I need you to the pain away, okay? I need you to me cross-eyed.
I don't want my son to see this.
I don't need my son. Listen to me, and you listen good. I need you right now to my immediately. If we don't immediately... I'm going to have to go back out there to my son.
You're killing this poor guy over here, man. You're hurting me, too. My ribs are fine.
No, you take off those snow pants and you me, and then I'm you. Okay?
And so he said yes.
Okay, yeah.
Which was really uncomfortable, come to think of it now. Yeah. But when a guy says, hey, when a middle-aged chubby guy on a mountain says, hey, come behind the house. I don't want my son to see this.
Yeah.
And you go, okay.
All right, well.
Apparently he was disappointed because I was like, I think my ribs are broken. And he was like, all right, I'm going to call an ambulance because I have to do that. I go, fine, just do it behind the house. He's like, what? So that I didn't want my kid to see. So the ambulance comes. They don't even know. I just go to the hospital. I just go. Take me in the emergency room. I don't know if people know this, but if you get hurt and you go to the emergency room, they'll make you wait for hours.
Oh, you don't get a table immediately. I mean, there's been people at Johns Hopkins that have gone in with a shotgun blast to the abdomen that get caught up on crosswords, bleeding out, waiting for help.
Can't you use your celebrity?
Yeah, and I'm huge up in the mountains of New Jersey.
The Catskills of the...
I mean, I really am huge. Yeah. I'm kind of huge everywhere. But
so you're sitting there, ribs are cracked.
So if you take an ambulance, you go right in. You go right in. They bring you right into a thing.
You walk in, you're there for 2 days.
It's a VIP pass.
Pro tip.
So that's why you got to go.
If you got insurance, take an ambulance. Don't be an idiot.
Okay.
So I go right in. I'm sitting there.
Keith, they're looking for you over there. Yeah. Door, by the way. Take care. There goes Keith.
Sorry, buddy.
Love you.
And so they take me in. And I'm sitting there for a while. They check me out. And then... I kept seeing this older guy just coming out from a curtain with no shirt on, with the hiccups going, can I get a Tylenol? I thought I was dead. And then I heard this woman in the next room with the curtain just speaking in tongues.
Oh, it hurts so bad.
She was like, oh, squat the feet. Dude, it was... It was exactly. I was freaking out.
Now you take care of her first.
How'd you get that footage?
So, and then I look up and there was a drop ceiling in a hospital. I was I felt like I was at a bad Italian restaurant.
What Civil War triage tent did you take me to?
And there was like a ceiling fan. I was like, what?
At this point, are you looking down at yourself and inspecting the area? Are you seeing the purple and the black and the discoloration?
No, I can't do anything. They have me in a neck brace because they have to do that.
Okay.
In case it's a spinal injury. Then they bring me into the CAT scan. They bring me into the x-ray. And they come back and they say, okay, listen, here's the deal. You're fine. You have no neck injuries, no spinal injuries. Your ribs aren't broken.
Your
ribs are probably cracked. You probably have a few cracked ribs. I go, what can you do about it? He goes, absolutely nothing.
Nothing.
Yes.
Nothing.
Say it again.
Nothing. So they go, we're gonna call you a cab. We're going to call Mickey. But if he is taking his sleeping pills, he's not going to be able to come and get you. But...
The cab driver?
Yeah, Mickey. They go, but he's honest with us. He lets us know when he took him or not.
Listen, I'm not going to be there in time.
So they had to call Gladys because Mickey apparently took his pills. And Gladys is a talkity woman, right? She stopped and got scratch tickets on the way, dropping me off.
The light's green.
Todd, fixing to move.
Okay, we're going. Okay, for the love of God. I mean, if you ask for painkillers.
Then they probably tell me no.
Calm down, Gladys, all right? Calm your old ass down. So you've got this relic driving you back to the mountain.
Yeah, in a minivan.
This dust-covered, forgotten daughter of the American West.
Yeah, she's got a flip phone.
Yeah.
She's using a tom-tom.
I'm calling my grandson. In 100 yards, Michael left.
So basically nothing, right? Just for the pain is all you get, right?
I had nothing. They gave me, I got a rib bra. Do you know what that is?
Yeah,
is
I do.
It a girdle?
It's a big elastic band that you pull, stretch, and then wrap it around your ribs.
Velcro it, right?
But yeah, Velcro. Mm-hmm. But the problem with that is that it looks like I have a bustier on because it mushes my boobs up. So I look like a hooker from the 1600s. So I can't wear it on stage.
You look like one of the wenches from Medieval Times that just turns the A cups into a D by just shoving it up into that shelf. That big, dumb wench shelf.
Yeah, I should have a medallion between it that's like a gold nugget some prospector gave me.
Yes, exactly. You show up out of nowhere. Yes, hello. Welcome.
It's hard to breathe with that on too, right?
Well, you can't breathe. You can't take full breaths. You can't sleep with it because you'll die.
Yeah.
So you
can't cough. You can't sneeze.
Well, so, you know,
I've never had a broken rib, but I've heard that is one of the most miserable experiences that you can have. Even a cracked rib,
it's the worst.
You can't not think of it.
Well, it gets bad and good. Like right now, I'm all right. Last night after the show, I couldn't even sit in the bed, so I had to find some weird position to lie, and it was like on my face, on my right side. With my legs shaped like a four, and my arms shaped like an S, and then my right cheek could go down. But if I moved at all, I was in agony and pain. So, yeah, you can't. I tried to pleasure myself.
Not good idea.
You cannot with broken ribs. Oh. Listen to me. You cannot. I had to throw my underwear out last night. Listen.
Oh, no.
Not because of that. So there was another thing that happened.
Multiple problems.
I have a bucket called diarrhea.
What?
Well, I have a bidet at my house, so I'm very lucky.
Let me turn this up, old money.
So when I didn't do anything while we were away on vacation, mm-hmm. Thank God. The medication they gave me just shut down everything. But when we got back, I finally did my thing.
You were able to make dire.
Right. So I fifth function. So I have a bidet at my house, which helps me out. It's the best.
Ooh, that's good.
Oh.
Oh yeah.
Oh, I've trained. I can open it like a dolphin hole.
Wow.
sorry.
Oh, that's real good. There you go. Yeah.
Oh.
No. I've never used a bidet. We had a bidet conversation recently here about all of us maybe getting bidets. Josh, being one of the cleaner members of the show, doesn't like just reaching up into that scum
because
trench.
I started using baby wipes recently.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And yesterday, things got a little messier than usual.
Yeah.
And I actually used, I had to use 7 baby wipes in
seven.
A row.
Jeez, that's a record.
Yeah.
Wow. I could clean it up a crime scene.
Yeah. Yeah, well, you know, you can't throw baby wipes down the toilet.
But it says it's flushable.
Yeah, there's some, right?
It's so bad.
Yeah, it's a lie.
You're not supposed to. What you're supposed to do is use toilet paper, right?
Yeah.
And then the last one, you use a baby wipe just to say, okay, let's get the peanut butter off. Okay?
Oh, God.
So, but then what do you do with the last?
And then you take that one, because there's not that much, and then you roll it, take it, wrap it in toilet paper, and put it in the garbage.
But then it stinks, doesn't it?
No, it's just a little bit. It's a little schmutz.
You gotta get like
schmutz.
Dog mess baggies and like seal it up like the plastic so the stink doesn't come out.
Yeah.
When they cleaned out, what do they call it? That grinder pump of mine that was all like logged with diapers and rats. They
the
found
septic tank.
It went to the plumbing. They found in my grinder pump, it was filled with baby wipes.
So, yeah. But how do they get away with saying it's flushable?
But it's some technical thing, but you're not supposed to do it. Yeah. What you do, like I did, you spend $200-$300 on a bidet.
Oh, yeah.
And let me tell you something. It cleans like it has. Mine has heated water.
Oh.
A heated seat.
Oh, yeah.
Mine has a an enema function.
Well,
you know, if you know, you got some of it. You know what I mean?
What's that? A stronger stream?
Right,
is that what that
well,
is?
Well, you ever see when they're mining on the side of a mountain and they're spraying the water?
Yeah,
you had my curiosity, but now you have my attention. So there's an enema function.
So it gets all that stuff out,
right?
Uh-huh.
And it just, I'm going to look into this.
Uh-huh. And then you have I have a dryer. So you can hit the dry option on the button.
It'll dry your ass.
And it has a little
How
fan.
How long are you in there?
Well, you got you do got to spend. You're absolutely right on that. You're going to spend a long time for the dryer, but it dries it out nice enough so you it's not the wettest. You know what I mean?
You might still give it a light dab, but you're not.
You have to give
dripping.
It a dab.
You're, you're not dripping anymore.
And there's nothing.
Wow. Is there any downside to it? I mean, do I have to try this out before I buy it? Or should I just buy it?
It should be like a car dealership.
You could use my, I'll use my bidet, then I'll use my finger, put it in peanut butter, and I'll eat the peanut butter off my finger.
That is clean. By God.
That's the commercial I sent
that?
Them.
Yeah, how's that for a testimonial, yeah. Josh?
Wow.
Yeah, you should get a bidet, okay. Dude.
But you said $300. That doesn't sound, because there's a separate plumbing that has to be
here's,
run,
here's
right?
What you do. Most people think you have to go get the other toilet, like the French.
Right.
Okay, don't do that. Just go, you get it's a toilet seat. You take your toilet seat off, you get a T-split, split the water going into your toilet.
Mm-hmm. That sounds hard.
I love this.
No, it's not. It's a T-split. So instead of a one split, it's a T-split. You're splitting, so there's water coming up mm-hmm. from to go into your toilet. You take that, you put the T-split on, and some of the bidets come with it, and then you take the seat off, put the new seat on, and then you're clean for the rest of your life.
Oh, my God. Guys, we're going bidet shopping with the quickness. Oh, you know my old trainer, Alex, who now lives in Colorado. He followed Joe Flacco out there because just people abandoned me daily. He once went to Italy with a girl.
Yeah.
And first time he ever saw a bidet.
Yeah.
And 100% chance he took a right in it. And
you're not supposed to.
Yeah, he didn't know that. Yeah, he definitely just lobbed a 3-footer into the water. And then some pissed off Sicilian comes out of, who to go to the bathroom? He did the bidet. And just like curled this viper into the water.
It was an American one.
Yeah.
Because they like once a day over there, they got little tiny Italian ones.
Little rabbit nuggets look like Skittles.
Yeah, we have a Babe Ruth cigar inside of there. You have to eat Pringles and pizza and hot dogs and hamburgers to make that.
Just this awful birth. You have to have a midwife to bring it into the world. Bob, take care of those ribs. Take care of those lips. Your skin is impeccable.
Thank you, buddy.
The next time
it really
I want
is.
You in here with just the ribs feeling a little bit better.
I will.
We are all going bidet shopping because of
you. I want you to thank me when you...
Yeah, I'm looking into it. Seriously.
Thank me.
Today.
Okay.
Yes, get it today. And if not, you know, make a coat hanger and, you know, put a piece of... we'll talk about that next time.
There are lots of ways to listen to 98 Rock every day. 97.9 FM, streaming live on 98online.com. The 98 Rock smartphone app on iPhone and Android and on your Amazon Alexa and Google Home. Make sure to follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/98online.